Hello and welcome back to another video of Formula One Challenge. And as I promised, this time we're going to do something slightly different than usual. So today we're going to start this live career mode that I was talking about over the past couple of days, just to, you know, change up the content, do something different than Formula One races of the old days. So here we are in the British Formula 3 in 2009. I'm going to play as myself, as a, well, for now, not very promising driver. But yeah, we'll just see how this is going to play out. After that, we'll move on to the Formula 3 Euro Series. And well, we'll just take it from there and see what happens. And obviously, I'm going to involve you guys as well as much as I possibly can with decisions, where to go, which team to choose, this kind of stuff. And before we start, just a couple of things how this is going to play out. So the way it's going to work, it will be that obviously I'm going to go through the entire season on 100% race length, because these races are actually pretty short. So that's what we're going to go with. The full race length is gonna be, I think, 25 laps or something like that. And I also changed the qualifying settings, so it's gonna be pretty much a two-shot qualifying and 15 minutes. So a very short one, just to make things fast, because I'm going to include the qualifying sessions in these races. And so this first one is going to be pretty much a kind of test run. And yeah, we'll see how this is going to work out. The other thing I wanted to mention, that I can't drive anything that has been created after 2000. So for now, I pretty much feel like I've come here to suck big time. I did a free practice session just to get a feel of the car, to get used to it. And well, that hasn't been going really well, to be fair. So yeah, this is gonna be a pretty interesting season of British Formula One. And here we are with race one in the Alton Park circuit. And unfortunately, I will have to use the camera you see on the screen, the T-cam, because the cockpit view is not very good. In fact, it's pretty disturbing. I actually have the feeling that this mod is pretty much an R-factor conversion. But this was the only one that contains these old seasons of Formula 3, so that's what I'm going to go with. And at some point, I might actually turn off the HUD as well, because it just limits the view. It has a strange design, and I just can't really see a lot. So for now, I'm going to go with it. But yeah, at some point, I'm probably just gonna turn it off and try to read off the information I need from somewhere else. Or maybe I'll do some editing myself and just move it or change the size of it at least, because it's just huge. But you'll see that pretty soon. So as I'm getting ready to do my turn in qualifying, and I actually had quite a bit of trouble setting everything up, because the mod is in Portuguese and my knowledge of Portuguese is as good as non-existent. So it wasn't the easiest task to accomplish, but I feel like I set up pretty much everything by now. And a couple of more words from about this mod is that, well, it feels pretty realistic. And I actually managed to blow the engine on one of the free practice sessions, right? So the qualifying has started, and despite I set it up for 15 minutes, it's only 10 minutes. So I think I'll just head out and do a qualifying lap and see where I will be ending up on the grid. Based on the free practice sessions, I'm not gonna do too well here. I also got some settings ready, which may or may not help me. The acceleration is down in the cellar, so we'll see how it works out. And here we go. I actually remember this track from Project Cars, and that helped me a lot with getting used to the layout and what's where. However, the car's handling is definitely a bit harder than it was in Project Cars. And to be fair, I never really seen a mod in Formula One Challenge that has this thing going on. When you mess up the gearing, it will blow your engine. But this one actually does, so I need to be really careful. As you know from the 70s season, sometimes I like to go crazy with the gearing or just press the wrong button or do something stupid like that. So actually I will have to avoid moves like that if I want to go anywhere in this British Formula 3 racing world. And here we are starting our hot lap. I wanted to use somewhat less fuel for the qualifying, but I cannot go lower than what's currently in the car, so that's not helping me either. And that was me going crazy with the gearing already. So yeah, we'll see what the lap time is going to be. I'm not expecting any wonder. Right, the hairpin can be pretty dangerous, and I actually felt that the car is way too over responsive, especially in the slow corners. So now I'm having a massive amount of understeer to compensate for the oversteer that I was having. And yeah, that's gonna be a pretty poor lap, to be fair. And the guy behind me is actually a lot faster than me. I'm holding him up right now. And here we go, I ran off in the corner. So I have one more shot to get a usable lap time. And I keep getting these messages of what's going on around me on the track. However, I don't understand the word, because that as well is in Portuguese. So probably something like there's a spinning in wherever. Oh, and that was it with the qualifying. And yeah, oh boy, 133. Yeah, that mistake definitely doomed the entire session. So now we'll just wait and see how the others do. As you can see, they drop 127, and I think I could have gone with the 129, 128 maybe, if it wasn't for that massive mistake in the corner. So yeah, that's probably gonna be P22 or something. And as you can see, we have a couple of familiar names all over the place. Max Chilton, Valtteri Bottas, Gilles Bianchi. So plenty of drivers who actually started here in the lower divisions and made their way up to Formula One. Esteban Gutierrez, Marcus Ericsson. So yeah, we have a nice amount of familiar faces here on the track. So we're in for a pretty interesting season. And yeah, on the way I will have to learn a lot about these cars and how exactly they handle. That might actually help me driving the bigger cars later on if I get there at some point. So Merhi did a 130, so he's actually my teammate, and I think if it's not for the runoff, I could have beaten at least him. But it is what it is. So we'll just see how this plays out. Satrio Hermanto, another 130. So yeah, I'm definitely gonna be way down the order. And I hopefully all the AI cars actually go out and do a qualifying lap. That's still more than half the pack with just a bit less than 4 minutes to go. And for now, I think I can see who the top guy is gonna be. As you can see, Nakajima is already on the provisional pole, followed by Sam Bird and Adrian Tambay on the first three positions. And see, here you can see pretty much the guys within one, way within 130. And we have another one. Gutierrez with another 127. And it's 3 minutes to go to the end of the session. And it's still half the pack that needs to get out and do a qualifying lap. And yeah, we're gonna be the lame guys here, especially myself. Not the best qualifying session. I'm not particularly proud of it. So yeah, we'll just have to live with it for now, and hopefully I can do better on the next session or on the next race. And I'm pretty curious how the race is going to play out. I'm actually pretty excited about it. Someone just returned to the pits. So let's see, Wayne Boyd. We're going to have a ride with him. He's about to. He just started his fastest lap. And we're just sliding down the order all the way. So let's see how crowded the track is. Doesn't look too bad, to be honest. Chilton is out as well. Merhi is here. Enrique. Marok is coming back. Bottas is coming back as well. Where is he starting from? No, he's going out. Okay. Well, my bad. Well, I don't think he will have enough time to finish a fast lap here. So, yeah. Okay, so this helps me to start from the middle of the pack or something, but I'm pretty sure it will happen, as it always does in this game, that when I move to the next session, it will auto-generate a couple more times, so I'll end up down way down the order, somewhere at the very back. With such a horrible time, it's not gonna be anything else than last place. So I'll have my work cut out for me. And it's 10 seconds left of the session. Yeah, as I said, Bottas is not gonna be able to finish his fast lap. No, that was way too late to go out. yeah, that's pretty much it. How is he allowed to go out for another lap? Seriously. Oh boy, yeah, okay, so this one is working pretty well. As far as I can see. So I'll just get back to myself and we'll just move on to the next session, because it looks like the AI is just gonna do an endless amount of laps despite the qualifying being over. So here we go. Yeah, just as expected, gonna be starting from P20. So not necessarily the result I was hoping for, but it is what it is. Just have to suck it up and go through with it. So it's gonna be 25 laps. Let's see how much fuel I can take. Oh, 18 laps worth of fuel, and that's on normal fuel usage. Well, then, how should I go about this? So let's try just a bit more than 13 laps of fuel for the first stint, and then I'm gonna do a pit stop with pretty much the same amount of fuel to make sure that I have enough till the end of the race, in case for whatever reason I would be using more than the counter is telling me. So yeah, with this we're pretty much ready to go and do some racing. So here we go. And yes, as you can see, way far in the back. And actually the car setup I did gives me a very slow acceleration, but it yields me somewhat better grip in the corners and a slightly higher top speed. I mean, there are pretty little that I can do in terms of setting up the car. What are you doing, mate? And there is a yellow flag, so something must have happened. However, I have to admit that the AI seems to be fairly disciplined compared to what we can see in the 1972 season. Oh, that was a nice move going around the outside of me. So we're up to P14, and as you can see, I do have a superior straight line speed, and these guys are pretty aggressive when it comes to defending positions, so this will definitely be very interesting to play out. However, I'm glad that I feel like I did a pretty good job with the car responsiveness, and I'll need to get used to the braking distances for now, because so far I feel like I'm braking way too early, but sometimes I try to take a shorter brake distance and just slide off the track, so that will definitely need some getting used to. And it's already 3 seconds ahead of me. Yeah, I have no chance to catch up with those guys in the front, and I'm pretty much gonna hold up the other folks behind me. Oh boy, that was harsh. I was a little bit overly aggressive on the throttle on the way out of the corner, and I actually need to be very careful with the curbs as well, because they can be pretty dangerous. As you can see, these are pretty much 3D curbs, so if I hit them I might end up spinning. for now it looks like I can hold some of the guys behind me. That's mostly because there is very little space for overtakes on this track, even with these cars that are actually quite small. Wee little coffins. Right, so need to be careful with the throttle from this corner. I don't want to drift the car around once more. And I actually did pretty well out of the hairpin because I got some space between myself and the guy behind me. Wondering if the other guys are carrying a lighter fuel load, and if so, that might mean I might get something out of the pits just by going for a one stop. Hi, Nick. Thanks for dropping by. And yeah, Ericsson is having a pretty good day. And I said at the beginning of the video that I actually suck at driving these cars. I'm having a lot of trouble with it. So this will need some getting used to until I get to the point where I can be competitive with these. And yeah, we here in the back, we're just going to get lapped by the guys in the front. I mean, if Ericsson is 12 seconds ahead, then the race leader must be already half a century ahead of us. And yeah, as you can see, I'm pretty much holding up everyone here, but they are just unable to make an overtake. Yeah, I'm losing a good 2 seconds. 3 seconds a lap to Ericsson. And what grinds my gears is that even with the setup that is focused on higher top speed, I just keep losing a lot of time against Ericsson. So I'm not sure what's going on, but it seems like they have an even better setup. actually the first time I feel like I got a good exit out of the hairpin. And all I need to is to get a good exit out of this. But I think as I carry on with the race, I'll get more and more used to it. And I think in a couple of races time I might actually be able to do relatively well. But for now my biggest problem is finding the correct braking distance. If they feel like they are just way too early. And I wish I understood anything out of these messages that I'm getting in the meantime, but well, these are in Portuguese and well, I don't speak any of that, so. Oh boy, well, that was way too late. And Buzaid, or who, just took the position back, and I'm going to overtake him here. Or well, at least I'm going to try. And we're having some wheel-to-wheel action. So we're down to P14. Buzaid is starting to pull away. So I'll have to start being a bit more aggressive on the corners, which will result in two things. It's either going to work out, or I'm just going to fly off the track at some point and DNF out of this race. See, I had a little bit of a lockup going into this corner. And yeah, I'm still faster in the straights. But that's not going to help me too much here. With this track that has a lot of slow corners. Just the same mistake I did on the qualifying, and now down to P15. And look, there's another familiar face behind me, Merhi. Should be avoiding those curbs. It's a lot of danger. Oh boy. I should be focusing on the race instead of the chat. That may help somewhat. Yeah, so for now pretty much everyone is faster than me, so yeah, not expecting any great result. Already 4 seconds behind Hermanto. Five seconds, oh my god. That's just not going well. Bit of understeer out of that corner. Quite happy that I still didn't break the engine. Yeah, I agree, Nick. They are a bit OP on the corners, probably because they don't have the amount of understeer or oversteer that I had. So in the practice I had an enormous amount of oversteer and the car just kept going everywhere where I didn't want it to. And yeah, I tried to compensate that, so now I'm having a little bit too much oversteer, not even near as bad as it was with the oversteer, but it's not always ideal. Yeah, I'm going to get destroyed here completely by the AI. Not even the better straight line speed helps with that. There are just not enough long straights to use it to my advantage. Well, that was not very wise. Tried to take that corner way too fast. And actually, if I don't get the line perfect in the hairpin, then the car, the back of the car feels quite snappy. Oh boy, I did it again. Now, where he goes past. Yeah, I'm starting to feel like I messed up with the setup. They're just accelerating out of the corners far better than I can. And are just overall a lot faster in the fast corners than me. So yeah, for the second race I'll have a good look and see what I can do to get some better performance. Of course the race 2 is gonna be the race 2 of this track, Alton Park, so we'll still be here, and at least for now I'll have the experience with the track and maybe can set up the car accordingly, or at least to get something better out of it. I knew this was going to happen. Oh boy. I'm doomed. Yeah, this is it. Yeah. So I basically just tried if I can take the same braking distance as the guy in front of me, and no, absolutely no way. I just can't do that for whatever reason. So yeah, that's gonna be a horrible last place finish. And why do I have the pit sign out already? I'm not supposed to be going to the pits just now. Or at least I don't want to. I mean, the tires feel alright in light of the circumstances. And I actually still have a lot of fuel left. So the counter wasn't entirely right about the numbers. Right, okay. Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna do that pit stop the next lap. Shouldn't be touching those curbs. Well, so much about the tires. I just lost the grip halfway into that corner. Okay, I was way too fast as well, but should have a better grip than that. I mean, what do I know? Never driven any of these cars, so I honestly have no idea about how they handle the tires. But based on what I'm doing, it probably not too well. Absolutely no chance here. Well, this is gonna be an interesting season. Right, guys, give me them new tires. Well, maybe if you try to put them on the car, that would be of help. And I think I'm getting labbed. Hello. Nice to see you here. Okay, I have no idea how Bottas ended up so badly behind. Oh boy. Ay, ay, ay. Yeah, so that's my car's acceleration. So yeah, I think I definitely chose the wrong setup. Ah, well, Nick, it just happens. I'll need to learn this. This is not the 70s season. But yeah, I think today I'll do some practice just to get used to these cars and most of all the braking distances and the setups, because there is very little I can actually change on the car, so it's not like what I can do to my Tyrrell in the 72 season that I can just change whatever I want on the car. It's actually very, very limited. But regardless, I actually like this, so this is a pretty great mod. Only thing, I will have to learn some Portuguese to be able to understand everything. And if I counted everything correctly, then the AI should start doing pit stops within the next 5 laps. Oh boy, now I'm starting to have a lot of understeer even when I'm braking. But the positive of this race is, regardless of the bad result that we'll be having, is that it's a great opportunity to get used to the car, and I'm starting to feel more confident with it. But yeah, I definitely should have gone with a setup that's focused more on acceleration instead of speed, because I just feel like the car gets up to speed very slowly. Hello! Being lapped by someone again, or at least I will be soon enough. Yeah, so for the newcomers, so you guys know I'm replying to chat messages quite infrequently because I have a very limited visibility of the chat here, and I'm trying to let this guy go. Go, go, go. Get some speed, mate. And I'm also trying to concentrate on this race, though I don't really have any reason to do so at this point. And the last running place. And the AI should start pitting over the next two laps if I counted correctly. That's another blue flag. Come on, mate, go, go, go. Right, okay, I think everyone has passed. Gave me a nice opportunity to have a look at the chat. And, well, Rocco, I'm not entirely sure what you mean. Did you mean, what was that? Formula E? What? The race is over already? Right. Okay. Well, that sucked. That was a pretty poor race, to be fair. I'm not entirely sure what you mean with the radio, Nick. You mean the language? So yeah, here are the final results. So Daisuke Nakajima won the race. And... well, do we have any idea why everyone did 21 laps out of 25? That looks a bit strange to me. So it's Daisuke Nakajima, Sam Bird, Adrian Tambay, Pedro Henrique, Ricky Christodoulou, I guess that's Greek, Daniel McKenzie, Nick Tandy, Nicolas Maroc, Henri Arundel, Gabriel Diaz on the first 10 positions, and then after we have Marcus Ericsson, Esteban Gutierrez, Adriano Buzaid, and Satrio Hermanto. Yeah. Well, to be fair, this looks pretty strange to me, that this entire result screen and everything. Oh, yes, I think you're right. And if I actually remember correctly, these races are time limited quite heavily, or at least they were while this category existed in the state it's in at this year. So, yeah, this was a pretty interesting one. And I hope that I'll be able to get a better result out of this on the next race. And... and no one got any points because of the because we didn't get the time limit. Oh my god. Yeah, okay. I'll have to look at the settings and just extend it a little bit more, so no one actually counted as the official winner of the race because we didn't go the full race distance. That was just amazing. Right. Well, then that's how we roll now, and after I've done some changes to the settings, we'll go ahead with race 2, but that will happen some other time, because yeah, that's about it for this stream. So yeah, I actually enjoyed this quite a lot, and Yeah, I wanted to get the manual point system, but I can look back at this with you and just get them. But yeah, I'll have to do them manually. And after that, I just changed the time limit for the races so the AI can actually finish it and myself as well. But yeah, so all in all, I actually enjoyed this very first race of this Formula One Challenge live career in the British Formula 3 in 2009. So yeah, we'll keep getting on with this and see how well this will play out. I already got the next seasons and the next years ready and all kinds of categories. I actually wanted to go back in time even further, but I didn't find any good mods for the feeder categories in 2008. I found a few more back in time. So anyway, thank you very much for joining, guys, and yeah, I'll see you at the next race, which will be the race 2 of Alton Park, and have a good one. Goodbye.